know what, what's interesting about that, you mentioned earlier tonight that you win this past year's Royal Rumble. Anybody can win the Rumble.
You know, that's the good thing about the Rumble. I mean, there's so many guys out there just being in the right place at the right time. That's what it's all about.
This match is set for one fall. Introducing first from Cape Town, South Africa, weighing in at 213 pounds, Justin Gabriel.
And this is the final SmackDown of 2011. The high-flying daredevil, the Cape Town werewolf book, Justin Gabriel.
I'm telling you, this matchup right here, Justin Gabriel, better be on top of his game because this one is going to be awesome.
Oh, I love it.
And from Juarez, Mexico, weighing in at 205 pounds, Unico.
How much that ride cost right there, Josh?
Yeah, the Lowrider bicycle, very expensive. These are custom-made Lowrider bikes. We'll talk about those throughout the matchup. But earlier tonight, Unico, well, he had some words for the WWE Universe. Unfortunately, I don't speak Spanish, but here's what Unico had to say.
This is my homie Camacho from back in the barrio. As we are the Reyes back in the hood, we plan on taking over the WWE in 2012. Simón Este.
Interesting. So we've been introduced to Camacho, a buddy of Unico's, being brought up in the barrio. Of course, Juarez, Mexico, just across the Rio Grande River from El Paso, Texas. This matchup gets underway.
Hey, Cole, you were telling me earlier that you have a lot of knowledge when it comes to these custom-made low-ride bicycles.
Yeah, I do. Oh, geez. Tell me about a low-rider bike.
Let me explain or not. The Lowrider bicycle was developed in the 1960s. It was a way for the Chicano culture, the Mexican immigrants, to
check out Unico here!
Able to have class style when they couldn't afford the Lowrider automobiles. They basically started out with these twin bikes, and then they would, well, they would pimp them out, so to speak.
We're going to go quickly into the cover of Justin Gabriel.
With these long wheelbases and stylings, banana seats, sissy bars, the ape hanger handlebars. You see on this, This bike out here, overspoke wheels as well. In fact, many people date this back to Eddie Munster developing the fad for the lowrider bicycle, his Dracula and Milo coach bikes.
How much time did you stay up last night Googling that information is what I want to know.
Booker, I live in McAllen, Texas. I know a lot about the culture.
So now Justin Gabriel trying to get something going here against Unico. You see the presence of Unico's buddy Camacho on the outside as Gabriel takes flight.
I'm going to tell you one thing about Justin Gabriel and Unico. These guys can match each other move for move in the middle of that ring, so you got to keep your eye on the prize, dog.
Tremendous counter by Justin Gabriel, who told me that in 2012 he wants to crack Booker T's Fade 5.
He's getting close, I'm telling you that right now.
Gabriel in position, but Unico quickly.
Keep dreaming, Gabriel. Unico's going to be in the top of the Fade 5 if this keeps up.
Let me tell you something, Unico, this guy, he's totally known for his high-flying, acrobatic move. Check this out.
Unico! That's gonna be it. Justin Gabriel looks at the outside leg. Wow! Unico,
did not tell you.
Here is your winner, Unico!
Tell you, Unico and Camacho, what a team. They're gonna be the real deal, I guarantee you guys.
I don't know a whole lot about Camacho, but Unico, this kid, has got a hell of a future.